Question. Do you see an Arcadian renaissance or a renewed cultural interest in hermetic subjects on the horizon? Danny Carey. Honestly, no. It seems like the essence of hermetic tradition has become watered down over the ages. For example, look what's happened to astrology. The recovery of our divine essence with regards to the fallen angel of matter hasn't been easy, especially with all the obstacles provided by the Roman Catholic Church and others. This is a continuation from the first video. If you haven't seen that, I'd recommend watching that first, since these videos will build on each other consecutively. If you don't understand something or have a question about things in this video, it might be answered by the first one. As with the previous video and future ones, all of what I talk about here are my discoveries and opinions, meaning you don't need to accept any of them. And again, it's better to regard some of this arcane stuff first as material to further and benefit music, art, and expression before you pass it through any filter of rational judgment.
People that are godless in some way, if they don't have some kind of belief, for lack of a better term, if you don't believe in magic on some level, your art probably sucks.
With Fear Inoculum, Tool somehow managed to create songs which contain sections, riffs, hits, patterns, and words which are numerically tied to the passage of time and the track length of the songs, and which reflect the track time numbers present at new sections and new bars.
It's real inspiring though, because you'll start to see patterns and the way that it relates in numbers to the words and stuff, and we'll explore that, and that kind of branches off into the artwork. You can actually kind of, that fuels the artwork a little bit, because now you have a discussion about, whoa, that's crazy, you're singing about this, that you reacted to our music and sang this, and now I'm telling you that this is what the music is saying, like mathematically, you know.
This is only most evident when using the flax and waves offered through toolband.com during the second run of the limited edition of the album, which I'm exclusively referring to. In the first video, I gave a series of numbers which I contend are the most important ones to the album. Among them was 17. Fear Inoculum, Tool's seventh release, is a work centered around 7, and 17 is the seventh prime number. 17 is a major exact time interval between sections in many of the album's songs. Songs like Fear Inoculum, Numa, Tempest are filled with sections which are always 17 seconds long. These are often sections in which a riff, pattern, or measure is repeated 4 times in a span of 17 seconds before the next new section or new cycle or new variation begins. For example, starting at 7 minutes and 17 seconds in Fear Inoculum, the intervals between sections are consistently 17 seconds long for over 1.5 minutes. At 8:42 in Fear Inoculum, after Maynard sings the last words of the song, a major climactic moment begins which lasts exactly 17 seconds up to 8:59. During this 17 second section, Adam and Justin each play a total of 58 chords. As I mentioned in the previous video, 58 in multiple ways is one of the most important numbers to the album, which is centered on 7, one of which is that it is the sum of the first 7 prime numbers, including 17, the 7th prime. There are 58 letters in the titles of the 6 proper songs of the album, meaning the songs containing lyrics, and Chocolate Chip Trip, the one segue of the CD version, making it 7 tracks, is 17 letters. The track length of Tempest adds up to 58, and the numerical value of the title Tempest is 85, a 5-fold multiple of 17. 58 and 85 are inversions or mirror images of each other. The 17-second section in Fear Inoculum, during which Adam and Justin play 58 chords, can be counted as 1 bar of 17-8, followed by 1 bar of 13-8, followed by 1 bar of 14-8, or in total 44 eighth note beats long. Not only is 44 a number with some significance to the album, it's part of the first whole number ratio of 44 divided by 7, which makes tau, 2pi, 6.28, but 448, or 448, has significance as well. 448 is part of the 64th multiple or octave of the pi approximation 22 divided by 7, which features in the album. Its 64th increase is 1,408 divided by 448, 128 elevens, 64 sevens. A seventh of pi, 3.14 divided by 7, begins with 0.448. The 3 additional segues of the full version, 7 words, are in total 7 minutes and 28 seconds long, which makes 17 in single edition. 7 minutes and 28 seconds is 448 seconds. In other words, the difference between the 7-track CD version and the full 10-track version is 448 seconds. Chocolate Chip Trip is 4 minutes and 48 seconds long. The cover words, Tool, Fear, Inoculum, consist of 4 letters, 4 letters, 8 letters. The digital root of 448 is 7. The number 64 on the album has some relevance to alchemy, birth, and spirit, which I'll be talking about in the next videos. The next section after the 17-second section from 8:42 to 8:59 begins with a 59 in the track time, which is the 17th prime number, and during which Danny and Justin each play a new movement of 58 notes in one cycle of 22-8, meaning 2 times 29 notes per one bar of 11-8. Including Adam's 6 chords in the cycle, the full number becomes 64. In the CD container artwork of the limited edition, the upper close-up on the funnel of DNA in the form of a torch features 58 full additional orbs differentiated by a highlight ring around them. Though it may be 59 since there is half of an additional orb at the edge. In the book version, it's 58. In this front-facing artwork of D.M. Turner, the centerpiece of the Great Turn, there are 33 eyes on the body, and 25 eyes when counting the head and only the implied sides behind him and not the covered sides. In total, 58 eyes. Tempest, the song with a length that adds up to 58, may bring to mind thunderstorms, and coincidentally the wind speed classified as part of a severe thunderstorm is 58 miles per hour. 17 can be regarded as a number of alchemy and the squaring of the circle. Fear Inoculum, to a large thematic degree, fundamentally expresses duality and the interplay of opposites. In the most common system of alchemical operations, the septenary or the seven stages, the first and seventh step are bound to each other, and the alchemist begins where he started. The initial square or cubic stone he began with now having undergone purification and perfection, being the greater stone, or the philosopher's stone, and the above and below being brought together. The alchemist has returned and is now in a greater state of clarity. This is comparable to the diatonic scale of 7 notes, where the next 8th note, the 8th step, is a higher octave of the original first step of the scale. Since Fear Inoculum is constructed by Tool to be a literal work of alchemy, something I'll have a lot more to say about in the future, it's important to point out once again that the numerical sum of all the album's tracks is 360. 360 and 7 are two numbers representing completion, a great work completed. The 7-track CD version is 79 minutes and 10 seconds long, which numerically adds up to 89, and then resolves to 17. 8 and 9 are the first whole numbers to make 17. 8 and 9 is also the first whole number pair to approximate the squaring of the circle, since a square with a side of 8 units and a circle with a diameter of 9 units will have almost equal areas. Squaring the circle is a geometric representation of alchemical unification of opposites. 17 can express the unification of 8 and 9 and connects the first and last step of the 7 stages of alchemy. Tempest is filled with sections that are always 17 seconds long. The vast majority of the entire song is in 21, or 7-7-7.
3 rounds of 7, it's 21.
The majority of the midsection of Tempest is in intervals of 17 seconds. In the track list of the full version of Fear Inoculum, Tempest is the 17th word. The few 4-4 sections after the intro are always 13 seconds long. 13 is the 6th prime, 17 is the 7th prime. 6 into 7. The track length of Tempest resolves to 6-7. Both 13 and 17 exhibit a 7 characteristic, since 13 is also the 7th Fibonacci number. Tempest is the lunar song, and the intro and the vast majority as of 11:50 to the end is always in sections of 18 seconds, which relates to the moon. The sum of square numbers 6 and 7, 36 and 49, is 85, the numerical value of Tempest, the track with a length that resolves to 6-7. Tempest is 7 letters including the 7-4-T and is the 7th CD track. In Tempest, starting at 9 minutes and 43 seconds, a new section where Maynard starts singing again begins, which lasts 17 seconds up to exactly 10 minutes. 9:43 contains the digits of the full length of Tempest, 943 seconds. During this 17-second section, Adam plays a total of 59 notes, and 59 is the 17th prime number. At exactly 10 minutes, for the first time in the song, Adam starts playing a riff which counts out to 17 notes for every repeating bar of 21. Keeping in mind the title of the song, Tempest, which invokes flood imagery, Maynard's apocalyptic words in relation to a future cataclysm, the inclusion of calendrical and processional numbers, which I won't go into here, and the song's track length adding up to 58, the numerical value of Noah who survived the flood, it is perhaps relevant to quote the following passage in Genesis 7 verse 11. In the 600th year of Noah's life, on the 17th day of the second month, on that day all the springs of the great deep burst forth, and the floodgates of the heavens were opened. 600 seconds equals 10 minutes, and starting exactly here, Adam starts playing a riff of 17 notes in every measure. Two intervals of 17 seconds sections later, starting at the central lunar climactic moment of the song, 10:34, the cycle becomes 21:4, during which Adam plays 2 times 17 notes. 600:17:2. Remembering Danny Carey's hint of sixes into sevens, and Maynard's sung words of tempest, torrent, and rain, it's purely coincidental that the Great Flood is announced in Genesis 6 and occurs in Genesis 7. 17 is a flood number. Noah's Ark stood still on the 17th day of the seventh month. If you read Jung, you will be aware of connections between the Great Flood myth, a tarot card like the 17th card, the Star, and the alchemical operations of water. This is not the first time that Great Flood imagery features on Tool's music. Number and geometry contained in the Pentateuch and Revelation feature often in disciplines like Hermetic and Freemasonic mysticism, and this also wouldn't be the first time the mathematical structure of Tool's music is related to scriptural geometry and allegory. In apocryphal mythology, the great-grandfather of Noah was Enoch, the seventh pre-flood patriarch who was informed of a future catastrophe, interceded for the fallen angels, and was taught by the heavens scientific, astronomical, and calendrical knowledge, which he passed on to his descendants before becoming the highest archangel Metatron. Just as a side note, Metatron is the namesake for the sacred geometry pattern called Metatron's Cube, which featured in Tool art like a variation of it in the Opiate reissue, or in Danny's shirt and Theogeneration. The depicted astronaut may be the same figure as the one in the video for Tool's recent quasi-song, The Witness. And that video is 7 minutes and 37 seconds long, which in single edition just so happens to make 17. Enoch and or his descendants constructed two pillars or two monuments before the imminent destruction of the surface of the Earth. One to withstand water, one to withstand fire. The heavily layered title Fear Inoculum, when spoken, contains the name Enoch, and this too isn't the first time Tool used Enochian material. Here's an example. May of this year will be the 20th anniversary of the release of Lateralis. In the first video of this series, among many other firsts, it appears to have been the first time ever mentioned that the original track times of the Lateralis CD add up to 365, the ascribed years lived by Enoch. The title Lateralis is a composite of multiple words, including Lateralis. In several old Freemasonic manuscripts, the brick material of the Pillar of Enoch designed to withstand water was called Lateralis. In comparative mythology, Enoch is syncretized with Thoth, Hermes, Mercury, Hermes Trismegistus. The Pillars of Enoch are equal to the Pillars of Hermes and the Pillars of Thoth. Here's a quote from Maynard's book A Perfect Union of Contrary Things. His, meaning Maynard's, collection of Campbell and Jung held a prominent spot on his bookshelf, and on the rare nights when the parking lot was quiet, he lay in his bunk and read of the characters that populated dreams and legends. Kings and peasants, giants and gnomes, gods come down to earth in the guise of serpents and great birds. He'd come to recognize the Shinto priests and the African bushmen, the ancient Pima Indians, and Noah and his sons, as no different from the leathered punk in the mosh pit, or the hipster who sulked in the shadows of English acid. They must all in the end come to terms with love and sacrifice, death and resurrection, and great floods, actual or allegorical. The great equalizer was the story repeated across time and borders as each embarked on the same hero's journey, face the same perils, suffer the same heartbreaks on their way to enlightenment. Tool have always placed elements in their albums that are designed to accompany them into the future and will have personal relevance to the band members years after an album's release. An example would be Maynard including Saturn return imagery in Lateralis in 10,000 Days, decades before his second Saturn return. Fear Inoculum is Tool's Saturn return album, and numbers as early as 56, then 57, 58, 59, which appear all over the album, are also second Saturn return years. Keeping in mind sixes into sevens, for millennia the view from Earth projected outward at the sky meant the outermost planet to the eye, Saturn, was number seven. On the Tree of Life, the sphere associated with Saturn is the third, the first of the three supernals, whose name has a numerical value of 67. This sphere is the first above the barrier of the abyss, at the center of which is the hidden 11th sphere associated in the modern system with Uranus. A major subject on the album is breath, spirit, air. Concerning that, Saturn entered Aquarius, an air sign, on December 17, 2020, and the great conjunction between Saturn and Jupiter occurred on December 21, 2020, commencing a new roughly 200-year cycle, seven generations, of great conjunctions and exclusively air signs of the zodiac, starting with Aquarius. Some astrologers consider this a kind of announcement for the age of Aquarius. The zodiacal association of the 17th tarot card, the star, is Aquarius, which in classic astrology was ruled by Saturn, and in modern astrology by Uranus. The defining astrological events of 2021 are squares between the 6th and 7th planets from the Sun, Saturn and Uranus. The first square between them will have them both at 7 degrees. Fear Inoculum has been out for 17 months, and the name Tool in reduction equals 17.
And it's fun to watch people try to dance in 21 or 17.